Hello everyone, Dustin here, and today I'm going to show you how to draw a spur gear from scratch in Fusion 360. There's actually lots of videos on this out there, but the one difference that's going to be shown in this video is I'm going to show you how to draw an involute gear tooth profile from scratch. Alright, so the first thing we're going to do is just set up some parameters that we can use for our gear creation. I've got this nomenclature photograph here on the side here that we can use as a reference, but there's actually only three parameters that we need that really will serve to define the rest of the gear properties. So let's go ahead and add some parameters. So the first parameter we need is called the modulus. We're going to set that to be 2. What that is essentially a number that defines the size of the gear teeth. Next we're going to add a parameter that defines the number of teeth on the gear. We'll call that num teeth. It doesn't have any units. And we're going to, for this example, just say that we've got 20 teeth. And the third parameter that we need is called the pressure angle. And what that is, it's essentially the angle that the gears mesh at. So it defines the curvature of the tooth. So we're going to set that to 20 degrees. There's really only a few standard angles that are used for the pressure angle, 14 and a half, 20, and I believe it's 25. We want degrees for that. And those are our three primary parameters. Now from those, we're going to actually calculate a number of other parameters that'll help us from having to calculate them in line when we're creating our model. So let's create one more. So knowing the number of teeth and the modulus, we can define the pitch diameter. So the pitch diameter is simply going to be the modulus times the number of teeth. The pitch circle, that's essentially the diameter that we just calculated. We need a few other diameters that'll help us out. So the next one we're going to calculate is the base circle diameter. And this will be used when we get into defining the involute. So we'll come back to that here in a minute. But the base circle diameter is simply the pitch diameter times the cosine of the pressure angle. Next, what we want to do is we want to define the top of the tooth and the root of the tooth. So if we look at the diagram here, the addendum is shown as a measurement from the pitch diameter to the top, or the tip of the tooth, and the dedendum is from the pitch circle to the root of the tooth. So let's define those two first. We'll define the addendum, in this case, to be just 1 times the modulus, and the dedendum is going to be 1.25 times the modulus. So now that we have those two calculated, we can actually calculate the addendum circle and the dedendum circle, or in this case, I'm going to call out the addendum diameter and the dedendum diameter. So we'll call it addendum diameter. So that is going to be the pitch diameter plus 2 times the addendum. And the reason it's 2 times is because, remember, we're talking about diameter here, so we have to add the addendum to both sides of the gear to get the proper diameter. And lastly, we're going to calculate the dedendum diameter, which is going to be the pitch circle, or the pitch diameter, minus 2 times the dedendum. Okay, so those are really all the parameters that we need in order to define at least the basic geometry of our gear. I'll come back in a minute and show you how we're going to do the involute. Now that we have our parameters defined, let's go ahead and start laying out the basic geometry for the gear. I'm going to go ahead and create a new component. We'll call it Spur Gear. and it's already activated. So let's go ahead and create a sketch. I'll put it on this plane here. And let's start out by laying out some construction lines for some of the basic geometry of the gear. We'll create a circle with a diameter for the pitch diameter. So that's 40. Zoom in here. Let's lay out another line for the base diameter, which is just slightly less than the pitch. One more for the root of the gear, which is the dedendum diameter. And the last one we'll put on here is the tip diameter, or the addendum diameter. And last, I'm just going to add a line here for the center line, just like that. So that really defines the basic geometry, or at least the diameters that we need for the full gear definition. But next, we want to get into drawing the tooth profile. And like I mentioned at the beginning, we're actually going to draw a true involute tooth profile. So it's going to have the proper curvature instead of just a shape like you see in some other videos. To develop our involute gear tooth profile, I've actually put together a spreadsheet that will calculate the curve for us. So let's jump over to that now. So the link to this spreadsheet will be in the description below. It's free to use, so feel free to check it out and hope you find it useful. First, we just need to put in the input parameters that we have for our gear. So it'll be the same ones that we put into Fusion 360 earlier. So we've got a modulus of 2. Number of teeth is 20. And the pressure angle is 20 degrees. That's really all there is to it. So the spreadsheet goes ahead and calculates the pitch circle diameter, the base diameter, and the tip diameter. And then it goes through a series of equations here to calculate the gear tooth profile points at various radii from the origin. So what it does is it starts here at half of the base circle diameter. So it's half of 37.59 is 18.79. And then I've designed it so that it produces 15 points at equal increments up to half of the tip diameter. And you can see in the formulas there, we've got pretty simple formulas for the first and the last. And then the interim points basically just divide the radius into equal steps. The end result is a series of X and Y coordinates that define these points for the curve. Now, you'll notice here that I've got results in millimeters and in centimeters. One of the quirks in Fusion 360 is that we'll see in a minute, but when we import this into Fusion 360, it expects the numbers to be in centimeters, not millimeters, which is a bit counterintuitive since the coordinate system we've defined as millimeters. But now that we've got our curve generated, this is actually one half of the shape of the gear tooth from the base circle up to the tip. We'll see how to handle the root portion of the tooth once we get back into Fusion 360. But all we have to do now, because I'm using Fusion 360, I'm going to copy the centimeters, and we'll go into a new sheet here, paste those as values. And then what we want to do is export this as a CSV file. So basically just a text file with the numbers separated by commas. So let's go ahead now and import the gear tooth profile into our sketch. To do that though, we need to first actually close out of the sketch we were working on. And what we're going to do is use an add-in or a script to import the CSV file. So we'll go up to Tools, Add-ins, Scripts. And then if we scroll down, there's one here called Import Spline CSV. That one's going to let us import the points that we have saved in our CSV file. So we'll go ahead and run that. We'll click on the file and open it. And as you can see, it actually imports the spline right into our model here. If we look closely at it, it looks like it's lining up properly. So it actually starts on the base circle and goes all the way through to the tip. So what we want to do now is define a mirror line that we can use to project the other side of this tooth. So we'll go ahead and we'll draw a construction line from the origin out to the tip diameter of the gear. And then what we're going to do is we're actually going to define the angle of this line. So if you think about it, we've got a gear that's 360 degrees total. And to break that into the portions of the gear for each tooth, we can divide by the number of teeth. If you think about it though, that spacing actually includes the space between the teeth as well as the tooth itself. So to get just the tooth portion, we divide by 2. And that would be the entire width of the tooth. We only want half of it to define our mirror line, so we want to divide by 2 again. Essentially what we're doing is just dividing by 4. So that works out to an angle of 4.5 degrees. There's one more issue we need to deal with though. If we look at the pitch circle diameter, which is this third construction line here, we can see that the tooth is already up from the x-axis by that point because of the involute curve. The width of the tooth is defined on the pitch circle, so we actually want to define or determine what angle this is and add that to our mirror line so that we can get the full width of the tooth. So let's draw another line from the origin to the intersection of the gear profile on the pitch circle diameter. We can determine the dimension or the angle of that line, 0.853 degrees. So now if we go back up and change our formula for this gear, we want to add 0.853 degrees to that. And that should be the true center line of our gear tooth. So what we want to do now is just define half of the tooth tip and then also define the portion of the gear that goes down to the root. So let's use our line tool, turn off construction lines because this is going to be actually part of the tooth profile. And we want a line for our gear tooth tip, and then we want another line from the lower end of the spline to the dedendum. So that's half of our gear tooth fully defined now. What we can do now is actually mirror that across the center line that we just defined. So we'll choose our mirror tool. For the objects, we want to choose all three components of our tooth. And then for the mirror line, we're going to choose the mirror line that we just defined. And there is our fully defined tooth. Now that we have the tooth fully defined, we just need to add in the gear body. What we can do there is we can just select the dedendum gear diameter and project that into the current sketch. And that defines basically an enclosed object that we can use to extrude. But before we do that, let's just zoom out a bit. And let's add one more circle in the center here for the shaft. Let's say that we've got a 10 millimeter shaft. That's really all we need to finish our gear. So let's close the sketch. Let's go ahead and press E to extrude. We want the main gear body as well as the tooth. And let's make our gear 5 millimeters in thickness. And new body is fine. Okay, so there's our gear with just one tooth. Let's zoom in here, and I want to add a fillet to the edge there. So we'll click on fillet, we'll choose that edge as well as the one on the other side here, and let's just use a 0.5 millimeter radius fillet. And let's zoom out here again. And now what we want to do is just use a circular pattern to copy that gear tooth all the way around. So we can go up here to the Create menu, choose Pattern, Circular Pattern, and the pattern type we want is bodies. We want to duplicate the body here. So let's go ahead and click on that. And then for the axis, we want to rotate around the Z axis. So we'll choose that. For quantity, it's actually just the number of teeth that we want on our gear. So we've already got that defined as a parameter called numTeeth. We'll choose that there. Hit OK, and it actually produces our gear for us. Now, one small thing we need to correct here is we actually generated 20 bodies. What we can do is we can actually combine those into one. So we'll go up to the Modify menu and choose Combine. Target body, you can choose any one of them. And then the tool bodies is really just the rest of them. So if we draw a box around the rest, it selects the rest of them. We want a join operation, and we don't want a new component. We just want it to combine it into a single body within our current component. So we'll click OK, and now we just have a single body. So that's our gear fully defined with an Involute tooth profile. So one check I like to do is actually to compare the gear that we've produced from scratch to one of the ones that's produced by the add-in. So if we go up to Tools, Add-ins, and then Scripts, there is actually a script built into Fusion 360 that produces Spur Gears automatically. So let's go ahead and run that. And what we'll do is we'll put in the same parameters that we used to produce the gear that we just did from scratch. So the pressure angle was 20, module was 2, number of teeth was 20, root fillet radius was 0.5 millimeter. Gear thickness, I think we used 5, and the hole diameter was 10. So let's go ahead and hit OK. And what that does is produce another spur gear on top. Let's go ahead and activate that component and try to rotate it so that it perfectly overlays the gear that we produced ourselves. So let's just play with the rotation here. Whoops, I've got faces selected. So let's try that again. Let's hit OK there and just go back to the base object so that we can see both. And it actually looks like it's perfectly overlapping. If we turn this one off and on, looks like the rotation is just off ever so slightly, but it's essentially the same gear. So that's it for today, guys. I hope you liked this video and found it helpful. If you did like it, please go ahead and hit the like button and subscribe to the channel. Thanks very much. Bye-bye.